someone's getting a visitor.
In the longleaf pine systems we've got in the southeast, there are three species that are endemic to those pinelands. They don't occur anywhere else. Those are backman sparrows, brown-headed nuthatch, and the red cockaded woodpecker. Those aren't found anywhere else in the world other than in our southern pinelands. There are several other species, like northern bobwhite, that occur elsewhere, but their numbers reach their highest numbers in those southern pinelands.
Red cockaded woodpeckers make their cavities in longleaf pine trees that are at least 90 years old.
Are you ready for a red cockaded woodpecker? Just starting to get a little feathering.
Aww.
Look at that. Wonderful.
Hi, baby.
But see, he still has about another 20 days before he'll fledge from the nest and actually fly on his own. So he's got a lot of developing yet to do.
This bird is just 7 days old.
I bet about 10,000 of these birds are banded each year.
Well,
because they're banded on all the managed areas of state and federal lands that hold them.
Red cockaded woodpeckers are endangered, but their numbers are rising. It's a species that researchers watch closely.
Sit down. Now that's just like you wearing a wristwatch the rest of your life.
Only 3 million acres of longleaf habitat remain from the original 90 million. Of that, only 10,000 acres have never been cut. That's tough on a bird that needs older trees. The Red Hills is a stronghold for the red cockaded and other longleaf-dependent species.
This is an old river delta that we're standing on right now that hundreds of thousands of years ago deposited some unique sort of clay soils here. And that scarp that's run on the south side of Tallahassee extends out to the Osceola River on the east and off to the Ocklockney River to the west. And those two rivers sort of form the boundary. And so we call this Red Hills region.
If you haven't yet gotten a good look at an eastern phoebe, there are two in this pine, three that way.
Jim takes an FSU biology class to one of those rare pieces of land where longleaf has never been cut. It's a birder's paradise. At Tall Timbers Research Station and Land Conservancy, Jim shows the class research plots burned at 1, 2, and 3 year intervals. Let's take a look between the pines. Note the openness of the 1 year plot.
If you listen to the naturalists that came through this region back in the 1800s, they described these areas as being these pinelands with a grassy understory. So it's a natural system that had these grasses that held on for decades and would burn very frequently. Basically, they support a lot of the species that are very important to these pinelands.
Funding for Roaming the Red Hills has been provided by Tall Timbers Research Station and Land Conservancy.